I just got the hull, just kind of got it taped together and just kind of mocked up. This is not the stand that comes with this. I actually 3D printed this stand. This stand goes with, and I hate to do it, but I'm gonna give away a secret. It's an upcoming project. It goes with, excuse me, a Disney Nautilus that I'm 3D printing, and I'm struggling, having trouble with the 3D printing on it. Some of the parts come out really good, some not so good. But this is a very low parts count model, and I'll show you real quick what parts we have. Here is part of the mast. Shift my lights around a little bit. And I'm completely stupid when it comes to shrimp boats and boats in general, but I will try not to be a complete doof when I name off these parts. Like, this is the wheelhouse, you know, the little cabin part there. These are what's called doors on a shrimp boat. It helps, the doors are out, are floating on the water, and it helps to keep the net spread out, from what I understand. And this is, looks like the roof of the wheelhouse and just different parts. There's a raft. Here is the deck plate. Here are, hey look, car tires. Oh, but damn. But they go on the side. So we're bumping up against the dock. And here is this little wimpy stand that comes with a kit. And there's nothing wrong with it. You know, once you glue it together and stuff, it does its purpose. It holds up the boat. But I like that stand better. And so I'm going to use that. And I'll just 3D print another one. Just print up another one for the unmentionable model coming up in the near future. Or in the future. I can't say near future if I keep having trouble printing out the parts. And then you got one part here that is, this is just an unfocused, there it is, exhaust pipe, muffler and stuff. So, clear parts, windows. I hate my camera. Windows here. And then you get a roll of black string, but as you can clearly see on the box, it only gives you the black string, but you can clearly see that you need a white string or cream color string or whatever. And I have this. I've got a humongous roll that would stretch from here to the moon and back. And I'll use that for this. I'll use the you know, this black string for everything else. And yeah, it's I like this because I don't have to make a damn thing look pretty. So, instructions. What is that? Here's the decals. Cue journey music. See that? It says Suzanne. Name of the ship. Name of the boat. It's such a pretty boat. Ship. And here are the instructions. Just a one sheet fold out type deal. I hate rigging on airplanes, and I despise rigging on ships. This doesn't have very much, so I'm not worried about it. And that is it. Like I say, I'm going to just continue working on it, and well, actually I had started working on it. I'm going to start gluing some parts together, and we're in a rainy part of the season right now in Florida. And right now we're under a severe thunderstorm watch, and if you can't hear it, you hear, you know, I'm in a metal building, so you may hear tapping or whatever, and it gets harder at times. It's raining outside right now, and I have a metal roof on my shop here, but I don't know what I'm talking about. Anyway, going to get rocking and rolling on it. I guess I could show more of the box. Here's the main picture of it. There's another shot. There's the stern. Suzanne. One of my favorite Journey songs. I am a big, big, big Journey fan. Journey is actually my favorite, with the Eagles following up after that. Journey, especially with Arnel Panetta, or Panetta, or however you say his name, revitalized my love for Journey. All right, working a little bit on the shrimp boat. I got the wheelhouse together. Top is not on because I'm going to paint the top separately. I can't glue the hull together until I shoot some primer on it. I think what I'm going to do is just hit the inside of this with flat black, because the wheelhouse does not have a floor in the back, and I'm going to paint the inside of it here probably an off-white or a wood color, maybe, I don't know. But I don't want you to be able to see down in there, just like the hold here. This has a plate that goes over it. Actually, all these have plates that go over them, so those be glued into place. But I don't want you to be able to see. You know, if there's a place that is not covered, I don't want you to see the white plastic, so I'm going to hit it with black. And once I get that done, then I'll clean this edge back off and glue everything in, and then hit it with gray primer and start doing, I'll start doing the woodwork. But I wanted to show you something. I was looking at this box, and, you know, if you're going to advertise a model, you know, have somebody that gives a damn. What do you see wrong with that? Where it says Suzanne. Anybody that has built models knows that that is the carrier film that is turned yellow. Now, they either built this model and it had old decals and they didn't give a damn, they didn't care about it, or they had this model built for quite some time and said, hey, let's take pictures of your model and put on the model box. I don't know. But the another thing here on the back, right down through the middle of it, they couldn't be bothered to fix the seam. I just thought that was crazy. Like I say, if you're going to put a model on here to advertise your model, then see, now that's not as bad. You know, at least put one on here that looks, you know, that you don't see the obvious problems, right? Okay, working some on the shrimp boat, and everything's just stuck on there. I've got the paper towel shoved down in. I painted everything inside black, flat black, and then I shoved paper towel in there, and then I hit it with gray primer just on the inside here, and then I hit it with white primer on everything else, and I'm going to lose the wheelhouse. Hang on. Forgot about the wheelhouse. So take this off for a second. You see I got paper towel shoved in there. I hit everything else with white primer, and that because part of this side of the hull here is going to be white, and you can barely make out the line that runs, if I can quit shaking. You can barely make out the line there that runs all the way across here. It's nice of them to give me a paint line. That will get the red undercoating or reddish brown undercoating. I see pictures of where it's just strictly brown. Well, I'm going a different route with this. So, and let's see if I can get the wheelhouse sitting on there halfway right. There we go. Suggestion was made to copy the roof of the wheelhouse to make the floor out of, because I mentioned there was no floor in there, and as you can see, that's not feasible. If I was putting lights in there, I would worry about it, but I'm not putting any light in there. I'm not gonna stress over it. I've decided to rename the boat. It's not going to be, you know, Suzanne, and I'll reveal the name of it at the end of the video, or at the end of the build. So Oh, on the stern, you can see on the side here how it's got the lines. On the stern, I sanded off all the lines just so I could address the seam. And what I'm going to do is come back in and pencil in the lines after I get the paint and everything on there. Whatever you're going to see, you know, you'll see some of it. So, and it's only from this line here down. So I'll pencil them in. And if I don't pencil them in, then they won't be penciled in. Either way, they don't matter. This is a fairly low stress build, but I really, really, really stressed out just, you know, not too long ago because I had had my parts in a little tray here. Some of those parts that are laying here, clear parts where's the wheels? Here's the tires that go on the side. Had all these parts in here and I really stressed out because I dumped my beer over into my parts bin. Spilled and spoiled a perfectly good beer over a model. If that don't stress you out, something is wrong with you. But continue working on it. Changing up colors. I decided that, you know, I said that, you know, I didn't have to make anything look pretty on this. Well, I've decided that I'm going to go with more of a desktop type model and not a realistic type model. And I apologize if you hear rain. It's starting to get a little rough. I'll stop here in a second. But I'm going to go with more of a cleaner version. So, all right, well, here's where I'm at right now. I've still got a bunch of parts to go through and detail paint. I've got some of them already painted up. And you can see a lot of them still on the sprue. There's not a lot of parts to this, but I'm just taking my time. And I have to apologize. I did lie. I said I wasn't going to spray anything. Turned out, you know, I was using a lot of craft acrylics on this. And the green stripe that you see is actually Folk Art Faded Jade Green is what that is. Had some in my stash. I still got to go in and paint the red water line, if you will. I'm going to do some trim work. You see this line here, and then the top rail. That's going to be the honey brown there, if you will. I think that's about what color that is. Painted the doors. I've got the deck plates or the hold covers painted. Just got the orange on the life raft up there. I haven't done any more detail painting. The craft paint that I'm using, it worked out fine for the white here because there's a big area. And the ceram coat faded jade, or I'm sorry, it's not ceram coat, it's a Folk Art. Man, this stuff went down like butter. I mean, it just went on really, really smooth. But what I've been trying to use, and I'm limited on what I have as far as white craft paint. Right now I'm trying to, you know, I was using this Crap Smart. Yes, you heard me right. Crap Smart paint. That shit just went on like chalk. And I had to end up stripping the wheelhouse. I didn't like the texture on it. And like I say, I'm going for a more of a desktop model. And the reason I'm going with the colors, I will reveal that at the final video. And the other white craft paint I've got is this Anita's craft stuff. And it works good if you're spraying it, you know. But, and the other paints work pretty good as far as colors. But when you try to lay that white down, man, I'd say that crap just turned out chalky and stuff. So I went in, and I've got to go in and touch up the edges of the inside deck. I went in and I masked everything off, and then I just took white Krylon and shot the inside of the hull here, inside of the hull on top of the deck. Because I tried brushing that with this craft paint, and just like a wheelhouse, it was just looking like garbage. And so I didn't want to go that route. And cheated once again. The
the mast is sprayed with Krylon. Now the undercoat here, this is all craft paint, and I'm going to mask off. It's already been flat coated because I didn't want to, when I put tape over it, I didn't want to pull the paint off. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to mask off the water line. And let's see. I'm going to try this cinnamon. I'm going to brush it on a piece of test plastic and see how it looks. If not, and I apologize, I had to get up for a minute. If not, I'm going to use this, painter's touch or master's touch. Or I don't know, master's touch. The way they wrote it, I couldn't read the thing. And I may use that on the bottom. I may darken it up with a little black or whatever, but I just brushed the cinnamon on a piece of plastic, and you can see the brush strokes there. It's still wet, but that definitely gives me the color that I'm looking for. And this is just one coat. So definitely, two, if not three coats will definitely get me in the color range I want. Probably just two coats will do it. So then that is just, it's an old bottle of ceram coat. I'm sure, I don't know if it's, by Delta ceram coat cinnamon. Where is it? Right there. So yeah, that color works out good. And a little tip that I do, I don't know if, I used to use a little paint tray like this, and you can see I've got some pigments there, some pastels in it. I used to use that a lot, and then having to wash it out and everything. Well, my family goes through lots of Gatorade, and I've got a box of Gatorade lids, and I've got a bag full down there, and I just use these little lids and put out some paint, and you could have 4, 5, 6, 7, however many you want. There's the one for the, I think that's the green. No, that's the crap smart. The white. Okay. But I just use those as little paint trays. And if you want to wipe them out, I've got a spray bottle. Where's my spray bottle? That's down there on the floor. But I got a spray bottle here. I just hover it up, hover these little caps over the garbage can. Hit them a few times with the spray, and rinse them out, and they're good to go again. So, just a little tip for you. Don't throw away your lids. Now, like I say, the line there is going to be the honey brown, as well as the top rail all the way around. So, and that'll all be brush painted. This, that went on really well. The doors probably have about 7 coats of the mustard that I mixed up. Now I painted I mixed up that mustard color, and it is here. That's what this is. I mixed that up, and I painted the deck with it. Man, I didn't like that crap at all. I'm like, yeah, I'm going to have to fix that. But it worked out well for the doors. I wanted a little contrast on that. So, okay, but that's where I'm at, other than the mishap with spilling my beer and the crap smart paint. I won't ever use this junk again like this. I'm probably going to toss this white. It's just garbage. I may get rid of the rest of that Craft Smart. Funny thing is, I had a bottle of Craft Smart Black, and I really liked how it went down. I mean, two coats at the most, and it had everything covered. But the rest of this paint, I bought, I got this in a set, and that stuff, it's like painting with watercolor. You got to just keep coat after coat after coat after coat. And every time you put a coat on, if you don't get the coat before it nice and smooth, then the texture and the brush strokes or whatever, it all just starts building up. And if you put on 4 or 5 coats, hell, it looks like caca. But anyway, breathe. Catch you in the next update.
Well, I got a lot more done on the boat. The time has come to where I got to start doing rigging. You can see on the doors there that that I've got the ropes run through the doors, and this is what I'm using. This is pretty much in scale with the rope that I was going to need there. And then I've got the string. I've got easy line, but I think the easy line may be a little too thin. I'm gonna look at it and see. I'm either going to use this. This is the thread that was supplied with a kit. I'm either going to use that or easy line. It's according to how easy it's going to be for me to feed it through the eyelets, which I'm going to drill out the eyelets. You got eyelets all along the tops of the hull there for the rigging to come down and secure to. Everything is on the wheelhouse. The wheelhouse is actually glued down. I got the little life preservers on both sides, and you can barely make it out. I got the harpoons, one there and one on the other side. I've got the life raft lashed down. Pretty much all I have left, like I say, is rigging. I've decided not to go with this 3D printed stand, and there's reason for that is it's the wrong angle, and I was going to try to cut it off and, you know, reduce the angle on it so the boat would sit in there. All it was doing was catching the tops of it, but you can see how it is, you know, how it's made here. That I'm not going full with trying to cut that. I'll have another project for this to, you know, to mount upon, if you will. But this is the kit supplied stand, and it, like I said before, it works just fine. So once it's glued together, it's nice and sturdy, and I just got to go back in and prime it and paint it. This is probably going to be the wood going to use, and yeah, there's a hole right there where I had something mounted on it, but I don't have the opportunity to go out and buy a plaque to put this on, so I'm going to use what I've got. And I kind of thought I may put a little foot piece on each one of the bottoms of the stand there. That way, if I do that, then that'll cover up the hole. Not sure I'll do that or not. Here are the tires that go on the side. The rigging, they will be lashed to the eyelet, or not to the eyelets, but around the eyelets here. And then the rigging comes down, and there's separator bars, what I call separator bars right here, that separate the rigging. It'll come down, and then it goes off to one side, and then off to the other side, and then down to those eyelets there. But everything is, like I say, everything is done except for I've got to make up the decals. I was going to do it in vinyl, but since I've changed the way the name is going to be on here, I can't get the letters that small. I could, but it'd be extremely aggravating. So I'm just going to make use clear decal film and make the name for the front, and then the stern back here. I don't know what else to say. Like I say, got the, these are all the parts that I have left. I got, this is an antenna that goes on the top of the main mast. I say it's an antenna, I'm not sure. The separator bars, and then you got the little eyelet here for the inside of the main hull. And then I've got these, which are all, I want to say, turnbuckles for the rigging. And what I'm going to have to do here is, I hate to do it because they're black, but I'm going to have to use super glue to get the rigging to stick to it. But it's no big deal. I'll get it done. Don't know what else to say. I'm going to make a name plaque, like a commission plaque, to put here on the front. The reason I've gone, you know, some of you know, you've watched the video, but the reason I went from, my first intentions was just to make an old beat up shrimper out of this, you know, weather it up and,
you know, possibly have barnacles on it and all that. But I decided to turn this into a gift, so that's why I went with a more clean version and, you know, make it more like a desktop model instead of, you know, a realistic model. So, all right, and here's the final. And you can see the name on it. It's the Miss J.D. Boo. And there's a reason that I named it this. My granddaughter, her name is Jade. And she will be 17 years old here before too long. And for just about all her life, her nickname, you know, the name that I call her, her nickname was J.D. Boo. And I call her that. I don't call her that in front of her friends, but she's still my J.D. Boo. I love her to death. And so I thought she would be happy to have this, and because she's always interested in what I'm doing and everything. And so I built this for her. And I'm going to take this off the hook here in just a second, but let me show you something real quick. One thing that I didn't use, and that was these figures, who I have adaptly named the Flash Brothers. There's just so much flash on them. But yeah, they that's the only thing that, take that back, it's not the only thing that I didn't use. I ended up not using the turnbuckles, because these turnbuckles are tiny. I done one right there, and it just didn't turn out like I wanted it to, so I just went ahead and done away with the turnbuckles and done my own type rigging. So, take this off, and just kind of give you a once over. Like I say, the rigging could have been better, but I done the best I could on it. Got the red and green navigation lights, or I should say the pink and green navigation lights. There's the name of it, Miss J.D. Boo. And I made my own decals, and I've never had, you know, when I flat coated decal, I have always had it just about disappear, you know, the carrier film. But as you can see, the carrier film is on there. It's on every single decal that I put on here, which I just put three, but still. You can see the harpoon down there, the life preserver on the side, the life raft up top, and my half-ass rigging. There it is on the back. Brass propeller. And I went ahead and I went with a smaller display base and the original stand. And yeah, I didn't put any name on the plaque that's there. I just went ahead and painted it black. It's in the shadows and you're not really going to see it. So, yeah, there's the turnbuckle that, or not turnbuckle, but the block and tackle that I did and used. But there was supposed to have been another one here, another one there, in between this post and that post, or beams. You know, they're supposed to be in there. I mean, they're just, if I remember correctly, there's supposed to be one on this line that goes here. And yeah, with the trouble I had with that one, I knew I wasn't going to be doing any more of them. I got a crooked antenna up top. But that's it. Had some fun doing this. Very relaxing, with the exception of the rigging. You know, it's kind of getting a little bit irritating with the rigging as it does. But that's it. So on to the next project. There we go. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll catch you in the next video.